back with our favorite tambayan. Now, Carmina, let's move on over to a more eco-friendly spot. You know, corals and fish from the Philippines, ngayon, naka-permanent exhibit na siya dito sa San Francisco.
Nice. Exciting, JC, kasi marami sa ating mga Canadian ang nakakamiss ng Pilipinas at ng dagat. Isa na po ako ron. Ang iba naman, hindi pa nakaka-experience na sumisid dito at makakita ng coral reef.
Well, ito na yung chance nila na sumisid. Because sasamahan niyo po kami sa feature na ito as we take a glimpse at the richness of the Philippine coral reefs.
Big fish, little fish, lionfish, shrimp fish, susmariosep, even upside-down jellyfish, all living in the middle of Golden Gate Park in San Francisco. Binuksan kamakailan lang ng California Academy of Sciences ang kanilang Philippine Coral Reef Exhibit, the deepest living coral reef display on Earth. The tank was modeled after the real-life reef of Balayan Bay near Batangas in southern Luzon, one of the most diverse areas of marine life in the world. At take note, lahat ng makikita mong coral, original, hindi pirated. They were raised from smaller pieces taken from those in the Philippines, then grown in nurseries across the United States. Pati mga fil-am na isda na nandito, lahat first generation. Visitors discover what lurks in the deep without getting their toes wet. Mula sa pinakabulilit na sand eel na bumubulaga hanggang sa heavy-gutting giant clam, there's something on the menu for the entire family to enjoy. Ang kulang na lang dito, siren at siyokoy.
I love standing there and watching people come around that wall and see that huge view into the reef. And they literally stop and their jaws drop open and they go, wow! You also go downstairs and you'll see young children especially literally just pressed up against the glass looking at the fish and just sort of transfixed.
After years of research in the Philippines and tireless collaboration with grassroots conservation groups like Pusod Pilipinas and people of the local barangays, the exhibit has made strides and turned the tide in the effort to protect the world's many threatened coral reefs. The museum has honored some of those close to the project by including them in the exhibit, like Princess.
Before, our coral reef were almost dead and there were no fish. But after 5 years of protecting a marine sanctuary, the fish are back. By guarding the sanctuary, I guard my people's livelihood.
Every time I've seen Princess and talked with her, she's been wearing that same white hat and has had the same pair of binoculars. And she is vigilant. She is one of the counselors of her barangay. She almost single-handedly got her reef protected, even at times though she was being threatened by fishermen who were not happy being told they could no longer fish on this reef.
The museum hopes that through the exhibit, the message to explore, educate, and protect the ocean resonates with all you land lovers out there. Fish be with you.